الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. أما بعد، أحبتي في الله، Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remembers those people who remember him amongst the malaika, amongst the gathering of the muqarrabun. So, Ahabati filah, this shows us the importance of remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala often and in accordance with the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala, he said, may Allah have mercy upon him. He said, it is enough of an honor for remembrance that Allah the Exalted boasts regarding those who constantly do it. As is in Sahih Muslim from Muawiyah, who reported that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came out to a group of his companions radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in, and they were sitting with one another, and he said, what has made you sit here? They said, we are sitting remembering Allah and praising him because he guided us to Islam and bestowed on us. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, by Allah, is the only thing that has made you sit here with one another, meaning this, is this the only thing that has made you sit here with one another? They said, by Allah, nothing has made us sit here other than that. He said, I did not ask you to swear because I am not accusing you of lying, but rather, Jibreel came to me and said, Allah boasts regarding you to his angels. Ruahu Muslim. Ahabati fillah, it shows us that Allah Azza wa Jal is not only pleased with those who remember him, but he actually boasts to the malaika in the gatherings of the angels about you when you remember him subhanahu wa ta'ala. So to be of those who are closest to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then be of the dhakirin wa dhakirat, those who remember him often. Try your best. This is a simple task, that we remember Allah on our tongue often. Subhanallah, alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar. During your job, during your school, on the way to work, on the way from the store, on the way to the store, inside the store, wherever, try to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala often, as much as possible, as a means and a tool to help you cure your hearts, to help you refrain from sin, to help you protect yourself from the shaitan, wa shayateen, from the mankind and the jinn. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.